So now let's come to ceiling. Yeah. So we've got the racks in place, got the material handling equipment in place, all of it is in place. It's time now to improve the overall productivity, efficiency, and take it to the next level. Okay. And that's where you have specialists like automation specialists, you know, like Srinivas here, who represents the Vega company. And so now Srinivas, you know, we have this customer who's put all this stuff in place, and he says that as it is, I'm still sweating with all this investment. Okay. And you are now coming back and saying, you know, put this automation and all that. So the question I actually want to ask you, you know, because rather than creating fear, first of all, we need to create awareness and we need to make this entire system so exciting. I think than that, you know, I mean, two big guys and the rest of them two small guys, too small to be called big. Okay. So the point here is that, yeah, so they're buying stuff, they'll go into, you know, robotics, they will get the product to themselves, they'll do all that stuff. Okay. But the mass is not that. And I think here we don't have, we're looking at the mass here. The point is, what are the first baby steps we need to start taking in order to slowly start realizing the benefits of automation, fine, and start loving automation. And then we say, oh, now I can't do without it. You know, rather than throwing a sortation system on somebody's face and say, and you get scared with the whole thing. You know? So what are those baby steps we need to take?
First, Arif, thank you so much. There's a story to tell. Right from building and down to automation. Nice way of handling the panel. So what happens, this is basically a typical situation that we all face.
Yeah.
But in my standpoint, automation should not be looked at on a pure arithmetic scale of what is the return on investment, what is cost benefit analysis. That's a very, I mean, I would say very naive way of putting things across.
Yeah.
Simple arithmetic is, I invest X amount of money and I would save 10 people. I would get some, you know, reduction in errors. So X is equal to Y plus Z. But that's, the problem lies in the fact that there's a lot of intangibles that you're not looking at. If you're simply looking at ROI, I think stock market is doing well. Last 30 years, we've got 14% investment ROI from the stock market. So from the business perspective, one should be looking at ROI, but we should be looking at indirect correlation. What automation brings to the table is, apart from efficiency, operational efficiency and manpower reductions, which are a given, we should look at productivity enhancement, we should look at reliability, we should look at predictability of operations and business. Automation brings in not just operational efficiency, it brings in predictability of business. You know how much you can produce year on year, month on month, day on day. So the predictability is highly important for the sales and marketing team to be able to tell the customers this is what is the on-time delivery like. So I'm a strong advocate of looking at automation from the perspective of intangibles such as future-proofing your business. Let me take two examples. One example I take of Amazon 10 to 15 years ago when Jeff Bezos made all the investments, he wasn't looking at ROI. In fact, he never got his ROI till 2010, 2011. We invested huge on automation, not just because it is OPM, not because it is other people's money. He invested because he saw something that is future-proofing his business, in the sense that he is ready for the market. Let me take an example of two companies, companies A and companies B. Company A and B both manufacture similar product range, have a similar profit range, same width and breadth of product. Now let's say company A has a simplified warehouse, level one automation. Company B sees the future, invests in level two or level three automation. Obviously, company B's products will be slightly a tinge higher when compared to company A products. But then, by investing in level two, level three, level four automation, what he's bringing onto the table is the critical thinking to his entire team, ops and sales team, to see how well he can market my product. For example, if you take a company A, he's got a simple warehouse, so the number of SKUs you can handle is much lesser. Suppose I have automation, I can handle multiple SKUs. So I can ship to my customers a mixed pack. I can ship to my customers one product, two product, not necessarily a pallet load. Automation brings in the flexibility of your product range to the customer. So I would suggest my customers to not look at direct ROI, because ROI, if you're looking at you are not looking at business ROA, looking at automation ROA, which doesn't make sense to me. Business ROAs make sense to me. So I would want them to look at intangible benefits of how will I use automation, leverage this to further my business. That is what I would look at.
I think you brought a very new and a completely radical approach to the way generally that people are thinking in terms of not looking at the machine ROI, but looking at the business ROI, which I think is a very nice and important way. However, I think it's also important, you know, from an Indian standpoint and from a mass standpoint, you know, and I keep telling people that the first thing that you need to take that baby step in automation is to see that if there are human beings carrying material up to a distance of more than 10 meters, put a conveyor in place. It's not automation. It's not automation. There's no science in it. There is, when I say science, I mean there is no decision in it. It just takes material from point A to point B, replace two people, do not make human beings donkeys, fine, when you have a machine in place.
I'll take leave for example, out of the presentation. I've seen your lovely presentation. Take leave out of that. See, obviously, you know, that 20 years ago, India missed the landline revolution. We jumped from no phones to cell phones per person. Yeah. One cell phone per person, we had one per thousand. Similarly, this our logistic industry or SCM
absolutely
is perhaps going that route.
Yeah.
There's something called a baby step that we're talking about is what we talk about mechanization.
Yeah.
Automation is one larger step. One baby step is mechanization, which probably we can use nature's gift, gravity. Because I would love to see warehouses, Indian warehouses, having a lot of, you know, gravity spirals for bringing goods down. Don't have to invest in a lift, no power required. We would like to point A to point B, use gravity to make it flow, gravity flow racks. All those things, I don't see them. Either we see ASRS high-end automation from Amazon, Flipkart and others, or zero automation, just space. So that, you know, that region, that domain that we are not occupying, we need to look at it. Perhaps consultants like you or system integrators like us should be advocating that and evangelizing that to a lot of those customers.
Do you know why it doesn't happen? I think the culprits are at the product manufacturing side or probably consulting side, you know. The point is that we all want to sell the fully loaded vehicle. We don't want to sell the basic vehicle because probably there's less margin in it. You know, the first thing we will go and tell somebody, you'll say, okay, put this conveyor which side you to take it left and go right. Like you rightly said, and I like the way you put it, you know, that you, instead of using, you know, motorized machine and electronic stuff, there is gravity available, which is the biggest form of movement, you know. Just run on gravity and don't take more than 2.5 meters of diameter for you to bring things from down to top. No, forget about a linear belt conveyor for that matter. So this is what I wanted from you.
One more example just before I conclude this part. The FedEx, when I'm talking about 35, 40 years ago, when they talked, they were getting loads of packages which have to be distributed in terms of geographically south, west, north, and east. They didn't go for high-tech sortation system, they didn't go for arm sorters those days. They just went in for gravity chutes, take up the product, dump them on a gravity chute, it comes down, a person sorts it on two sides, on left, two sides, right. This is west, east, north, south. And productivity went 30 times over. Same person, zero automation, gravity, no power required, they could sort 30 times better. So this, the ingenious method of looking at things in terms of automation, I would say mechanization, is what probably we, you know, as manufacturers have to drive. Like you said, we probably, the three seeps in that, can we sell more to them?
Yeah.
We have to move away from that.
Yeah, but I think, yes, so that's a big take to all of us who are dealing in this business, you know, that we should look at elementary level in, you know, infusion of technology. The moment you look at elementary level of infusion of technology, you will get people adopted on that page, and then from there we can keep harmonizing and making things bigger and bigger.